Half Speed and the Fruit Number.
The two things are really correlated. In fact, there is a famous formula for knowing which is the hull speed of your boat, which involves the length of the boat, normally in feet, sometimes in a correction factor, and the square root of the length.
The stiffness of the arm of, exactly. The, of the driver, the husband. Exactly. No, not really. It's just all about physics, no?
All about physics. Sì. In fact, that formula is derived from the substantially Froude number equal to 0.4. Mm-hmm. Froude number is one of the adimensional numbers which is used to calculate sometimes some critical facts of hulls and resistance. In this case, is used to calculate the length of a wave. 0.4 is the length which has to have the wave starting from the bow to have another crest on the stern. So if the wave has this length, the Froude number is equal to 0.4. The reason why the boat cannot overcome this critical hull speed, let's say, is because, in fact, this number is the length of the wave starting from the bow, and when the Froude number is equal to 0.4, the wave has the one crest on the bow and one on the stern. So actually the boat is standing inside the trough of the wave, exactly. And so has a lot of difficulties to overcome the wave in the front, exactly. Effect of at the bow. Mostly upwind, it's really difficult to overcome this kind of wave, but sometimes what can happen is if the boat is made properly and is also healed in the right way, the stern can detach the wake, so the wake is no more exactly at the transom, but it's probably some centimeters, maybe 1 meter behind.
So you are basically like driving a boat longer than you are driving actually.
Exactly.
Which can be the example, can be the 470 upwind in strong winds, when you have the crew hiking all the way, let's say, exactly. 100%, and you use the boat completely flat, and you see the boat is much faster than its hull speed.
Absolutely. Exactly.
So you completely change your mode of driving the boat.
Exactly.
And this is something you can also do on some other kind of boats.
Exactly.
For example, you tried this one 36, no? The
exactly.
new one, no?
For example. Mm-hmm. And you could easily see the wave and was not on the transom, what was I don't know, maybe 50 centimeters, 70 centimeters behind. So actually the sea sees the hull length as distance between two crests of the wave. So if the second crest of the wave is behind the stern, actually is like you have a bigger boat. This is obviously also true for the opposite. So if you have, for example, a really thin stern, so without a transom, but a thin stern, and probably you have a discontinuous point somewhere, then the length of your boat is the distance between the bow and this discontinuous point, which is creating the stern wave, in fact.
Exactly.
So, which is really badly
built
boat can have a hull speed which is less than the one you can calculate.
So let's compare, for instance, the like a classic boat with a like heavy boat with long long bow and long stern.
Exactly.
So obviously you have to drive it completely heeled in strong winds, because there is no point in keeping it flat, because starts to be shorter and then its weight and the depth of skill and so on cannot allow to overcome the speed, not at all. There is no way to overcome it. While a short boat, for instance, light boat with a flat bottom, then it's better to be sailed flat in strong winds, so you can go in a half planning mode.
Exactly.
Something like this. An example can be the Majest 20, for example. If you calculate it through the speed of the Majest 20 is actually smaller than you actually see on your GPS.
Exactly.
For sure is much smaller. So this is the reason. And if you look behind yourself, you see the wave that is
exactly
far from the hull.
So actually the hull speed, it's not definitive speed, but it's just the speed where you have a big hump in the resistance of the boat. So exactly. If you can overcome the hump, you will find your spot and go faster than you can. In fact, most modern boat can do this downwind or reaching, so when they are planning, but sometimes you can do something like this also when you are going upwind.
Sorry, but this hump is related just to the length of the wave, or is related to the shape of the hull as well? So I mean, we know where the hump is
exactly
because of the length of the wave, you know,
exactly
of the hull speed, you know.
But we don't know how high it is.
The hump.
So okay. Flat. If you take a flat boat in a flat mode, it depends on the angle of pitch angle of the boat itself. So typically what you want to do to make the boat start planning is to increase the your angle of attack, so your pitch angle. Mm-hmm. And then take the boat again a little bit flatter. So maybe you want to go like 7 degrees of pitch angle, and then the ideal pitch angle for a planning boat is normally around 3 or 4 degrees. So obviously bow up, 4 degrees bow up. Form of the hump is changing depending on the hull, a lot of factors. Obviously a big old boat, displacement boat, will have a so huge hump you cannot overcome. Mm-hmm. it unless you are in surfing mode.
Thank you. Ciao.
Ciao.